Greasy Stomp, it's the name of the tune. Bought it a couple of years ago. Guy in London, England, Greasy Stomp. You can find it, where did I get that? Anyway, kind of one of those tunes that I've got it on my, I got it on my iPhone even. It's just one of those I got to listen to every now and then. Hey. Why micro businesses? Why are you doing this? How to launch a micro business? It doesn't seem like the stuff that you do. It's not, which is exactly why I did it. So I wanted to kind of release this short video and hopefully answer this a little more precisely. I thought I had, but evidently I hadn't because I'm getting some questions about it. In my daily conversations with people and people who, usually, whether it's career, whether it's a career that they've already got, whether it's a career that they would like to transition to, whether it is some home-based business. But I would categorize the conversation primarily what we have come to know as solopreneurs. People that are kind of one-man bands. Now, that may not be their occupation. Their occupation may be something entirely different. And most of the time, it has been. But in the course of conversation, it became overwhelming how many people would admit that a relatively small amount of money would make a meaningful difference in their life. I didn't pick up on that at first. I just, you know, we would just trudge forward with our conversation and push the thing along. I've always been a big believer in aiming high, in big dreams. I think we need to be realistic. And I think in this internet age, there are so many people that look at an online enterprise very differently than those of us who really grew up in an offline world where we knew there was going to be a lot of hard work. There was going to be a lot of time spent, a lot of hours, a lot of brain power. Oftentimes an awful lot of capital so that we could get our businesses off the ground, so that we could gain some traction, so that we could get some momentum built up and establish a sustainable business. No more. The barrier of entry is just so incredibly low, but I also kept finding myself talking to people about things that they could do that frankly weren't just restricted to an online environment. It wasn't as though if you want to make a little bit of money, if you want to launch a micro business, then it necessarily must be an online enterprise. And as I began to think about this, and this has been going on for, I would say, since summer. So it's been going on for a matter of months. These two ideas intersecting of you don't necessarily have to restrict yourself to the online world, and you don't have to just go out there chasing five figures a month, six figures a month, six figures a year. Now that gets everybody's attention. No question. I mean, that there clearly are more people who, if given the choice, would you rather make $1,000 a month? Would you rather make an extra $100 a month? Or would you rather make $10,000 a month, $20,000 a month. Well, everybody's going to say, give me the $20,000 a month. Easier said than done. I mean, to go from scratch, to go from just a standing still start to getting a five-figure monthly income. Now, there are plenty of people that you'll find on the internet who can tell you that it's drop-dead easy. I would simply say if it's drop-dead easy, then why aren't more people doing it? The fact is it's not drop-dead easy. And the fact is that a lot of my conversations with people, it hinged around something that everyone in the internet space clearly understands. Not everybody honestly represents it. And that is to gain traction, to gain momentum, to gain eyeballs, to gain ears, to gain traffic. Big challenge. It's a big challenge. There's a variety of ways to do it. And I don't know that any one way is better than another. I think it depends on your proclivities. It depends on what interests you. There are people who have done it with search engine optimization. They love that stuff. They eat, drink, and sleep it. Other people have done it with pay-per-click. There's a variety of ways that people have done it, both free and paid. And as things morph, as things change, some things may get easier, but some things also may get harder. So as I saw this intersection of people who were expressing the idea that if they could just make a little bit of extra money a month, and it wasn't that I was shocked by that. And these aren't people, by the way, who are destitute. These aren't people who are unemployed. These aren't people who are making minimum wage. These aren't people who are in low paid jobs. These are people who are making decent money. Some are making good money. And no, I don't think it has anything to do with the economy. I think it's coming back to the reality of just how little an improvement could make a meaningful difference in people's lives. And so I began to ask, even people that didn't necessarily volunteer or it didn't come out in our conversation, I began to ask people, if you could launch some little side project, just something that maybe you've got an itch and you haven't scratched it, and it could make you an extra $100 to $1,000 a month, but no more. But if it can make somewhere between $100 and $1,000 a month, would that be worth your pursuit? And I have yet to get somebody to say no. Now, some admittedly have said, well, you know, if I did it and it just made me $100, I probably wouldn't be all that interested. But if it could make me $500 a month, you bet I'm in. I have not in the last, well, let's see, this is November. So we're going back five to 6 months ago. In the last 5 or 6 months, I have not yet encountered a person who said that if they could make somewhere between those numbers, if they could make that consistently month after month, that would not make a meaningful difference in their life. Because here's what people have related. It's a car payment or two. It's a mortgage payment for some. It's an eating out bill for an entire month. That seems to come up a lot. It's paying off student loans. It's paying down credit card debt. It's funding college for a child. So these are not grandiose kind of dreams necessarily. These are everyday lifestyle kind of things. People want to drive newer cars. They want to drive nice cars. It could make a difference in you being able to do that or not being able to do that. People like to go out to eat. It's a difference in you being able to go to a little nicer place or going to one not so nice or going out more. It can mean the difference in buying school books for your college-aged child and not having to go, man, alive, you know, that's our budget's going to take a hit this month because we've got to fork over $300-$400 in textbooks. So these are all real meaningful things. And as I kept encountering this and I kept thinking about this, and I don't claim that I'm the only guy out here talking about this kind of stuff, but I didn't see it. I didn't see it. That doesn't mean it's not out there. And as I kept thinking about this and I kept, you know, I'm like you, we get these emails and it depending on the list that you're on. And frankly, I admit I'm on too many lists. And the reason I'm on lists is not because I'm intrigued necessarily with the offer. I'm intrigued with the marketing. I'm intrigued with the process. I'm intrigued with the email flow and that sort of stuff. So, you know, I thought, well, you know, there's just too many people. I'm encountering too many people that amount of money would make a meaningful difference. And there are things that people can do. There's just things that realistically that people can do and they can kind of hit the ground running. So why not? So that's my answer. I hope that helps. Hey, the website is BulaNetwork.com, BulaNetwork.com. I'm trying to morph it. I'm trying to figure out what it is I want to do over there. You can help me. If you've got ideas, I'd love to hear it. You can drop me an email, results@BulaNetwork.com. You can even call. You can give me some voicemail. Feedback at 214-736-4406. 214-736-4406. I'll flash up a slide here at the end of this video, which I'm almost done. I appreciate you listening. Appreciate your time and attention. If you care to subscribe to the podcast, you can do that. You can find me on iTunes at Bula Network. Maybe just search my name, Randy Cantrell. You can follow me on Twitter, all kinds of cool ways to connect. Hope that helps answer some questions. And if you know anybody that's interested in, it's not a pitch. There's no marketing. There's nothing. I got nothing to sell. By offering the series of videos. I'm releasing them every week. And this week, part two goes out. So pass the word if anybody is interested in launching forth a micro business that could make them, hopefully, our target is to make $100 to $1,000 a month consistently over time. No guarantees. You may not make a dime. And you might make more. That'd be cool. See ya.